So this is something that I really commonly see in the gym, and most people don't even realize they're doing this, but ultimately it's gonna cause you to lose pressing strength as well as take tension off of the pecs and direct more of it onto your front delts. What's up guys, Sean Alawani, realscienceathletics.com. And in today's video, I'm gonna go over 7 common dumbbell press form mistakes that you should avoid, either because they're gonna reduce the overall stimulus on your chest or increase your chances for injury or some combination of both. Now, as far as free weight presses go, barbells or dumbbells are ultimately acceptable, but I do think that for muscle building purposes, a dumbbell press is going to be the better choice overall because it provides a more natural movement pattern and it allows you to get your shoulders and your elbows into the optimal position, which is harder to do when your hands are locked onto a fixed bar. Now, it is true that there isn't necessarily like one absolute perfect form for every exercise that every single lifter must follow. There is some individual variation at play because everybody's body structure and their overall training approach is gonna be a bit different, but there are general form cues that will work best for the majority of people out there and that novices should ideally start out with and then potentially adapt over time as they become more advanced. And the goal with this video and for any future technique videos like this is to just go over these points in a sort of quick fix checklist style fashion. So just to go over the main things that you need to know without getting overly bogged down in the tiny details so that you can take this information and you can apply it as efficiently as possible in the gym. And if you want to see more of these types of videos, then hit the like button down below and leave a comment as well to let me know. And if you're new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications in order to stay up to date on future videos. All right, dumbbell press mistake number one. Let's start with the initial setup, and that's leaning back while pressing the dumbbells up into the top position at the same time. So not only is this potentially an injury risk because you're pressing the dumbbells above your head from an unstable position, but you're also gonna be bleeding out a bit of strength on that first sort of rep that isn't actually a rep. So what you wanna do instead is to kick the dumbbells back and start the exercise with the weight in the bottom position. So make sure everything is lined up, gather your strength, and then perform your first full rep from that position. That way you're not gonna be wasting energy trying to lie back on the bench while pressing the dumbbells up at the same time, and there's also gonna be less of a chance of the dumbbells accidentally falling and crushing your face. All right, mistake number two, a really simple one, but also related to that initial setup, and that's putting your feet up on the bench. This doesn't give you any specific muscle building advantage, and all it really does is put you into a less stable position. Now, if you're lifting lighter weights for higher reps, then it's probably not gonna be a big deal, but if you're going a bit heavier, and if you're training within a few reps of failure, like you should be on pretty much every set, then you want your feet to be on the ground to give you a nice stable position to press from. All right, now moving into the actual press itself, dumbbell press form mistake number three is flaring your elbows out to your sides at 90 degree angles, or even worse, having your arms pushed back past 90 degrees. And I would say that most average trainees tend to do their dumbbell presses in this way. Now, for some people, this can be totally fine. Okay, I'm not saying that it's a bad thing in every single case and that it will automatically cause your shoulders to crumble and fall apart overnight. But if you wanna optimize the line of pull on your pecs as well as minimize stress on your shoulder joints, then you ideally wanna have those elbows tucked in slightly. Now, the exact position will vary from person to person, but around 75 degrees, give or take, that's gonna work well for most people. Now, if you're accustomed to doing your dumbbell presses with your elbows flared out, then this form modification might feel a bit awkward at first, but you should pretty quickly get the hang of it, and it is probably gonna serve you better in the long run. Okay, mistake number four is having your hands positioned either inside of your elbows like you see here, or having them positioned really far outside of your elbows. So what you wanna do instead is have your hands and your elbows stacked on top of each other like you see here. Now, it might not be 100% perfect, okay? If your hands are an inch inside of your elbows or outside, then that's probably fine, but it should be pretty close. If your hands are inside, then that's gonna put excessive stress on your elbows, and if they're outside, then you're gonna lose pressing strength and it's gonna stress your shoulder joints as well. Now, of course, if you're doing a dumbbell fly with lighter weights and a neutral grip, then having your hands positioned outside of your elbows is gonna be the standard form. But for a dumbbell press, you want those hands and elbows to be directly stacked on top of each other. And one thing you can do to make sure of this is to actually film yourself from behind the bench so that you can see exactly what your form looks like. By the way, if you're finding this video useful so far and you want some help getting your training program program onto the ideal path based on your current physique and your ultimate goals. Then once this video is over, don't forget to head over to seannell.com/custom. Just fill out the form there and I'll send you back not only a free step-by-step workout plan based on your individual needs, but also a nutrition plan as well. I'll link it up here as well as down below in the description box. Dumbbell press form mistake number 5 is pressing the weight in a diagonal forward path. So this is something that I really commonly see in the gym, and most people don't even realize they're doing this, but ultimately it's going to cause you to lose pressing strength as well as take tension off of the pecs and direct more of it onto your front delts. So instead, you want to be pressing those dumbbells in more or less a straight upward line. Now, since your elbows are tucked forward, it is going to angle back slightly, but the point is to press in a way so that you're generating maximum upward force against the weight and you're not allowing those dumbbells to drift forward. And again, this is something where taking a quick video of yourself can be helpful. Mistake number 6 when it comes to proper dumbbell press form, a very basic one, but also very common to see, and that is not using a full range of motion. So doing what a lot of people out there do and just grabbing onto the weights and pumping out a bunch of sad little half reps by only performing the top half of the movement. Or sometimes if someone is really going for that constant tension approach, then they'll just perform the bottom half. Now, if you want to maximize chest stimulation and growth, then you want to use the largest range of motion that you comfortably can. And that means ideally bringing the dumbbells all the way down to chest level, or at least as close as you can get them, and then pressing them all the way back up. If you're only doing the top half of the movement, then you're going to be working a lot more triceps. And if you're only doing the bottom half, then you will be hitting your chest, but just not to its full potential. And the research is pretty clear that for maximum hypertrophy, larger ranges of motion are going to be superior. Of course, you're not going to be able to lift quite as much weight this way in comparison to doing partial reps, but that's totally fine. The goal here is to place the pecs under as much tension as possible and slightly lighter weight, but bringing the dumbbells all the way down is going to be superior to using heavier weight, but only using half of the range. And lastly, mistake number 7 on the list, another pretty basic one, but that is not controlling the negative. Now, I'm not saying that you have to perform super slow negatives, and there is some debate in terms of how the eccentric portion specifically contributes to muscle growth, but I would definitely consider it suboptimal for most people to just be pressing the dumbbells up and then letting them drop all the way back down using gravity, which a lot of people do on this exercise. Okay, letting the dumbbells just crash down into the bottom position with no control at all, that's gonna increase the stress on your joints, and it also increases the chances for a sudden form slip up as well. So there isn't some exact cadence that you have to follow, but the bottom line is to lower the weight deliberately under control with some active resistance on the way down. And I think that if you're truly controlling the eccentric, then it probably shouldn't be done in less than, I would say about 1.5 to 2 seconds in most cases. Now, you can go slower than that if you prefer. I've always preferred slower negatives in my own training because it just feels better for me, but I do think that that's a good minimum to go by for most people. If you enjoyed this video, then let me know in the comments which exercises you want to see me go over next. Make sure to grab your free training and nutrition plan over at seannell.com/custom. If you're looking for premium quality, no BS supplementation options to maximize your results without all the usual hype and gimmicks, then make sure to visit realscienceathletics.com. This was all formulated by me from scratch using research-backed, clinically dosed ingredients only, and you can use discount code YouTube15 to save 15% off your first order. Here are 2 more videos I'd recommend watching now. You can follow me over on Instagram for more tips and updates. Don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications, and I will see you in the next video.